The NASCAR Busch All-Star Tour returned to Tri-City Speedway for the second time in as many years. The 1990 winner of this event and current NASCAR star Kenny Schrader returned home to defend his race title. Kevin Gundecker made his first appearance of 1991 at Granite City and set quick time. The Busch All-Star Tour inverts the top 20 qualifiers for two 15-lap heat races, with the top 10 making the feature. The number 25 of Schrader, qualifying third fastest, started next to the number 11 of Kevin Gundecker in the fifth row of the first heat. The near-capacity crowd's eyes were glued to these two competitors for the 15-lap qualifier as they swapped positions several times, working their way to a fifth and sixth place finish. Kenny Schrader and Kevin Gundecker would be among the 22 drivers from Iowa, Nebraska, Illinois, Kentucky, Missouri, and North Carolina to qualify for this 50-lap main event. Inverting the top six in qualifying, number 53 Joe Kosciuszko, three-time Busch All-Star champion, was on the pole. Number 37 Raleigh Frink started outside the front row. Current All-Star point leader Ray Gus Jr. and number 50 started pole in row two, with number 25 Ken Schrader on his right. Number 35 Ed Kosciuszko and number 11 Kevin Gundecker made up row three. Joe Kosciuszko led the first three circuits until Ray Gus Jr., taking the high line, powered past the Omaha, Nebraska native out of turn number two. Ray Gus Jr., trying to make it two tour wins in a row, would hold the point until lap 10. Gus Jr., trying to use a lap car to keep Kenny Schrader at bay, lost traction at the bottom of the racetrack, and Schrader bolted past to take the lead. Schrader, currently a Winston Cup regular, cut his teeth here at Tri-City Speedway, winning races since 1972 in stock cars and open wheel machines. Ray Gus Jr. held second place until lap 40 when he slowed and pulled off the racetrack. He relinquished his point lead to number 52, Steve Kosciuszko, who went on to finish sixth. The number 53 of Joe Kosciuszko brought home the runner-up spot, being the only other car on the lead lap. Bob Hill finished third, and the other hometown favorite, number 11, Kevin Gundecker, captured fourth position. Kenny Schrader, originally from Fenton, Missouri, led the last 40 laps of a race that went nonstop, green to checkered. The IMCA modified showed they also could go nonstop as they went 20 laps in their main event, only seeing the green, white, and checkered flags. By winning the second heat race, the 4S of Bill Simpson from Brownstown, Illinois, started front row outside of the main event and led every lap. The green flag dropped for the last time for the UMP Econo late models. 13 cars would go 20 laps to complete the night's racing. Racing Rick Baer, driving the number 7 car, flew past the number 9 of Tom Seitz to take the lead on lap number 2. The yellow flag flew on lap 6 when number 4, Kenny Bonnell, first had his front end knocked off, then was drilled by the number 16 of Bobby Simpson. When racing resumed, Rick Baer held the lead. Tom Seitz looked to be faster, but lost all hopes of winning when he hit the front straightaway wall. Rick Baer would go on to win the first Econo late model feature at Tri-City Speedway for 1991. Reporting for Winner's Circle, this is Chris Crone.
Thank you. Second row outside. 35 from in the third row. good this time. I've been listening to him the last couple of races. I don't know if he can. What's the starter's name?
What's your face, Robin?
Yeah, Robin, what's Bob Gordon?
Okay, drivers, we're going to go here and see you. Thank you. Come by the drivers of the NASCAR Busch All-Star Tour.